stage. You were good. I'm waiting for you to be great. And next, Kendall. You didn't stick out to me. Next is Brooks. Nia, you're third on the pyramid. You were third overall high score. And Mackenzie, one. And on top of the pyramid, going 3 for 3.
What's up, Brownsburg High School? Thanks for watching BHS TV. Today is Friday, March 10th. I'm Bolua Tifa-Olabi.
And I'm Ozzie McDaniel, and here's what's going on at BHS. Wearing a lanyard with your ID is a BHS expectation that helps us provide a safe learning environment for our students and staff. All students are required to wear their lanyards around their neck with their ID properly displayed at all times while in the building. Beginning Monday, March 13th, the loaner lanyards will be actual lanyards that must be worn properly and returned to the team office at dismissal. Failure to return the loaner will result in a detention, and damage or loss of the loaner lanyard will be a $2 fine. Students will not be released early from class to turn in the loaner. Avoid the inconvenience and possible consequences by making sure you have your own lanyard and ID each day. If you are unable to find yours, a new lanyard and ID may be purchased in the main office for $5.
Students taking the SAT this weekend at Brownsburg East Middle School need to enter door number 7 at 7:45 a.m. Testing will be granted promptly at 8 a.m. Students need to bring their admission ticket, photo ID, number 2 pencils, and a calculator for testing.
The French Club will be meeting on Thursday, March 16th in Madame Pardue's room B1404. They will be watching a Francophone movie. Please see Madame Pardue for more information.
The Chess Club will not be meeting today, Friday, March 10th. They will have one final meeting next Friday, March 17th, before spring break. Please see Mr. Dumstrom for more information.
Bulldogs for Life will have a meeting on Tuesday, March 14th at 7:10 a.m. outside door 14 to celebrate National Pro-Life Chalk Day by chalking pro-life messages on the sidewalk. Please see Emma Coyne for more information.
The Country Club of Indianapolis is hiring BHS students. They are looking for lifeguard services, buses, and golf cart services attendants. They offer competition play plus tip, flexible shirt, and schedules, evening and weekend shift, and practice and player privileges. If you are interested in applying for a job, please use the contact information on the screen.
Breakfast at BHS has been moved from Chef Central to Hotspot and Pizza Cutter. As always, in effort to serve you faster, please have your lanyards with IDs out and ready to scan at the register.
The Equality Alliance is hosting a prom clothes drive. Bring general use formal clothes to Miss Madden's room, C2317. A date will be announced later for when BHS students can browse the donation. Also, if you are looking for a community or acceptance, bring a celebration and snacks. Join the Equality Alliance at their meeting after school on Tuesday in the Edger High B.
Are you interested in serving on the BHS student government? Get involved with Riley Week, Homecoming, Shop at the Bulldog, and more by scanning this QR code or talking to Ms. Boffman or Ms. Baresky. Hey, how many bakers does it take to make a pie?
Let me guess, 3.14.
How'd you know?
Well, because we have a cringy toast line for holiday, and BHS TV Jonathan Harris has some more information about upcoming Pie Day.
3.14159265358979323846.
Pi Day, a niche holiday for nerds, I mean math lovers and bakers alike, to come together and celebrate pie. This year, we here at BHS TV wanted to do a little reboot of a game show from our childhoods. Let's play Are You Smarter Than a Math Teacher? Question 1. Whose birthday is also on Pi Day? Is it A. Albert Einstein, B. Sir Isaac Newton, C. Pythagoras, or D. Archimedes?
Let's go for A. Albert Einstein.
Albert Einstein.
Question 2. What year did Pi Day become a national holiday? Was it A. 2006, B. 1989, C. 2009, or D. 1956?
I hope it was D.
B. 1989.
Question 3. Who's credited with first discovering pi? Was it A. Pythagoras, B. Archimedes, C. Euclid, or D. Aristophanes?
I think C is always a great answer when you don't know the answer.
B. Archimedes.
Okay.
Right. Let's go.
And question 4. What fraction is commonly used in place of pi? Is it A, 22 over 7?
Yes, that one. I know that one. I actually know that one. So let's go with that one. Am I right? Yes. Okay, all right, sweet.
I'm going to say, was A, 22 over 7?
That is
A. A, 22 over 7.
A is correct.
Let's go. Let's go.
We hope you played along with our game in your seats and enjoyed your pie, whichever one you prefer. Jonathan Harris, BHS TV.
I'm kind of hungry now.
It's not that type of pie.
Yeah, you're right. Anyway, now it's time for sports. Hey, Mallory, what do you have for us today?
Hey, guys, we've got an exciting day coming up tomorrow for BHS Sports. Let's start off with the boys basketball team, who is in regionals tomorrow. Here's a look at the bracket for the tournament moving forward. Brownsburg will take on New Pal in Regional 5 on Saturday at Southport High School. That game will take place at 1 o'clock. The winner of that game will advance to the semi-state to take on the winner of Cathedral versus Ben Davis game. Starting this year, the regionals are now only one game, but the semi-state is now two games. The winner of the bracket on the screen will advance to the state finals to take on the winner of the North bracket. Good luck, guys. There will be a call-up meeting on Monday, April 3rd, for anyone interested in being a football manager for the 2023 season in Coach Thompson's room, A1-311, after school. If you have any questions, please see Coach Thompson. Our spring sports teams are preparing for the start of their season. We will have an update for you next week on when they get underway. The track and field teams will have their indoor Hoosier Crossroads Conference meet tomorrow at DePaul University. Good luck. That's it for sports today. Back over to you.
Thanks, Mallory. Now let's check in with Haley for a look at the weekend weather forecast.
Hey guys, we are going to see a little bit of a cool down from our recent temperatures coming up this weekend. Today, the high is 41 with a low of 39, and it will be cloudy with some high wind gusts. Saturday, the high is 46 with a low of 33. It will be cloudy, but we could see a little bit of sun too. Overnight into Sunday, we should see rain that could change into snow. The high is 41 with a low of 28. Those rain or snow showers will continue throughout the morning with overcast skies the rest of the day. Enjoy your weekend. Back over to you.
Thanks, Ailey, and good luck to the BHS choir who are hosting the Bulldog Spectacular Audit tomorrow. You can check it out live at bcsc.tv if you cannot make it to the high school to cheer the group on.
And that's all we've got for you today, BHS. Thanks for watching. Have a great weekend. We won't have a show on Monday due to our state broadcasting conference and awards ceremony. So we will see you on Wednesday.